Hello. Has your computer ever gotten so slow that you wanted to buy a new one? Well, we can fix that. So what I want you to do is click filehippo.com. The first program you're going to download is CCleaner. What CCleaner does is it gets rid of all the crap that you're downloading off the internet, streaming, watching YouTube videos. A lot of malware programs like to hide in these areas that it's going to clean. So click download latest version. While that is downloading, we are going to come up into the search bar here and we're going to type malwarebytes and search. You're going to scroll down until you see malwarebytes anti-malware and click the green download button. Click download latest version button. So while that's downloading, we're going to click on C setup down here that already installed. And you hit run and click next. Hit install. And I just unclick view release notes and leave run CCleaner checked, and I click finish. Now, when it first opens up, it's going to be in cleaner mode. What it's going to do, it's going to delete temporary internet files, history, cookies, recently typed websites, all of the stuff. And this is where malware do like to hide. So you're going to click Run Cleaner on the bottom right. And I usually check this box, Do not show me this message again. Because if I'm hitting Run Cleaner, I want to delete it. I don't need to be asked, am I sure? So I click OK. Now, if you do have the internet open, it's going to tell you, hey, we need to close it so we can clean it thoroughly. The second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Registry. Now, I've done this already today, so if you're installing it for the first time, it'll probably find over 200 problems, which is really good. So you're going to hit Scan for Issues. And it normally starts finding a bunch of stuff by now. So when it finds the things that need to be repaired, you're going to hit Fix Selected Issues, No to back up changes, and then you're going to Fix All Selected Issues and hit Close. Now, if it's your first time doing it or you're doing it every 2 weeks, hit Scan for Issues again because it'll find more, and then you'll hit Fix Select Issues when it's done. Another thing CCleaner does that I really like, if you click Tools on the left, and then if you click Startup right here, these are all the programs that are starting in your computer when you turn it on. A lot of these programs do not need to be running in the background. If you want it open, you can click it yourself. The more programs you have running in the background, the slower your computer is going to be and the slower it's going to boot up. So what you want to do is click on these programs, like the Adobe Acrobat Synchronizer, I didn't want running. So I hit disable and it'll say no right here. I wouldn't delete it, I would just hit disable. And then just go down to the things that, like if you don't want sticky notes coming up every time you turn on the computer, hit disable. If you use sticky notes, leave them. And just go down the list. If there's something you don't know what it is, don't touch it. If it's something that you know you didn't install, disable it. You can always enable it if it's something that you shouldn't have disabled. Another thing, you can click uninstall right here. And it's the same as going to your control panel, add remove programs. Here's all the things that you have installed in your computer. I like to go through and clean it up. If I'm not using something anymore, I'll uninstall it. So just go down the list and see if there's something you don't need, uninstall it. All right, so we're going to close CCleaner. We're done. What I recommend is using CCleaner once a week and using the cleaner part and registry. So we're going to close that. And let's go to the malware bytes download we just downloaded. You're going to hit OK. Next. Accept the agreement and hit next again. Next. Now this is a trick that I do as an IT professional. If somebody has an infected machine, or if you know that you have a virus or a spyware, see where it says malware bytes, anti-malware? I'm going to highlight just that word and I'm going to delete. Malware programs already know about malware bytes and they know that it's a very powerful removal program, and sometimes they write it in their code to override malware bytes if you're trying to install it. So what I do is you can name it anything you want, dog, and then hit next. So what we're doing is we're tricking any malware because it's not looking for a program called dog. And it's not trying to defend it or override it. Again, I'm going to erase this and I'm going to type our new program name, dog. And hit next. And next again. And install. I found this trick quite a few years ago when I was trying to remove a virus off of a machine. When I installed malware bytes, the virus disabled it right away. And when I tried to open malware bytes, it gave me a big error. So that's how I knew to change the name of the program. All right, you want to uncheck the box that says enable free trial of anti-malware premium. You don't want that. And then you hit finish. Now you will have malware bytes, and once you install that, you are going to hit update. It's going to check for the latest updates. Once it's been updated, it will turn green, and all you're going to do is hit scan now. Now, my computer, I don't think it has any spyware on it because I run this regularly. If you're severely infected, it'll automatically start showing the object scanned right here, and it'll normally show up with a bunch of programs in red, detected objects as well. So I'll come back once everything's done and show you how to remove it. Okay, so the scan is done, and obviously I don't have any infections on my computer. Now if I did, this is what it would look like. So if your computer was infected, this is what you would see. So it would all be red, and you definitely want to remove everything because it's spyware or malware. So all you do is click remove selected, make sure they're all checked, and remove selected. And then once you do that, I suggest that you reboot your computer. Once it comes back up, I would run malware bytes one more time just to make sure it gets everything. But you want to run CCleaner first once a week, say every Friday. Then once you run CCleaner, you'll want to run malware bytes. You run those two programs once a week, I promise your computer will run much faster and cleaner.